You're at 5326 to 5344 Dobry Drive, Sterling Heights, Michigan.
But Lukas Szymanowski says one of the more complex parts of the craft these days is getting their hands on aluminum cans.
Cans have been the biggest problem for us.
Brewers across the country are dealing with a can shortage. Bart Watson from the Brewers Association says when bars and restaurants had to shut down in the spring of 2020, people started drinking more at home.
Greater demand for aluminum cans, and that extended to other beverage products like soda, and so there simply weren't enough cans to go around.
That's been followed by ongoing supply chain issues, and the need for cans continues.
That is reporter Max Darrow. Coming up in 2 minutes after traffic and weather. A movie star's car sells for well over the pre-auction estimate. I'm Deborah Rodriguez. KFJ News Time, 12:38, traffic and weather together on the 8th Tier Streets of McCaskill.
And this report sponsored by Quest Research. Checking the AAA jam kicks here, continuing to track a busy drive with a new crash now. This affecting southbound I-75. At 375 crashing here, cars on the left shoulder. There's overpass and shoulder work nearby. Traffic is lower from Mag Avenue. This could certainly also affect people headed to the 1 p.m. Tiger Sink. Be advised of that. Going to be a busy drive. Vehicle fire cleanup is closed. The northbound U.S. 23 exit ramp to Michigan Avenue near Ann Arbor. So be advised, you're going to ease off the gas pedal, certainly making your way by. Slower traffic on going for work in Monroe County. Southbound U.S. 23 at Ida West. Single lane closed until 3, still dealing with a 15-minute delay through this area. On U.S. 23 at Thompson Road, left lane closed. Traffic slow in both directions. North and south on I-75, a busy drive between 696 and 14 Mile. The single lane closure's way has you very slow, in fact, along that southbound route. An update here in Commerce Township, Union Lake Road between Wise and Commerce has reopened 3 weeks ahead of schedule. So that's some good construction news there. And still over an hour wait for U.S.-bound cars and trucks along the Blue Water Bridge. Minimal delays making the way into Canada. Concerned about your risk of Alzheimer's? Quest Research is offering free memory screens and trial opportunities for new treatments to prevent memory loss. Schedule your free screen to prevent Alzheimer's. Call 888-QUEST-24. That's 888-QUEST-24. I'll have your next look at traffic, 1248 from the Rapid Roofing Traffic Center.
Heading into the afternoon, it's going to be warm and not too humid. We'll be up to about 86 or so, mid-60s tonight, and then mid-80s tomorrow with more humidity in the afternoon. And with that, a chance of a shower thunderstorm. Still a bit sticky on Friday, highs in the low 80s. It looks like the humidity lowers for Saturday. It's nice and warm and pleasant with that warmth up in the low 80s, and then gets warmer and more humid again on Sunday up to about 86, with thunderstorm chances trying to return for early next week. I'm AccuWeather meteorologist Dean DeBoer, WWJ News Radio 950.
It is sunny, 79 degrees in Rochester Hills. We have 84 reported in Canton. A late movie star's car has sold for well over what collectors were expecting. Sean Connery's personal James Bond car has sold at auction. Shadow gray 1964 DB5 Midas, the gadgets, guns, and ejector seat went for $2.4 million. Connery bought it in 2018, just 2 years before he died at the age of 90. No word on who the new owner is, but the winning package includes a drive chauffeured by Formula One legend Jackie Stewart. Part of the proceeds will go to the Sean Connery Philanthropy Fund. Deborah Rodriguez, CBS News. As teachers prepare for the return of students, some of them are preparing to do a lot more than teach.
At an elementary school in Maryland, there are students from 30 countries. At Templeton Elementary in Prince George's County, the hallways are filled with the sounds of 20 languages. The school has students from Mexico, Guatemala, El Salvador, Nepal, Afghanistan, Iraq, and Syria. In addition to making sure their needs are met, the students also have to be taught English. The principal estimates about three-fourths of the students grew up speaking a language other than English. Christopher Cruz, CBS News, Washington.
Two giant pandas have been born at a breeding center in southwestern China, a sign of progress for the country's unofficial national mascot as it struggles for survival amid climate change and loss of habitat. The male and female cubs are the second pair of twins born to their mother. Chinese veterinarians for years have been using artificial insemination to boost the population of pandas, which reproduce rarely in the wild and rely on a diet of bamboo in the mountains of western China. Coming up on WWJ.
Why are small cargo vans going away? I'm Autobeat reporter Jeff Gilbert.
Radio.com is now Odyssey. Download the Odyssey app and listen to WWJ News Radio 950 and all the news, sports, music, and podcasts that move you. Powered by Golling Auto Group. Experience the Golling difference at Golling.com.
Richard Bushingham. Sorry to interrupt, Sir Richard, but I'm Mark Tapper from Tapper's Jewelry, and the good fortune sale is... Fortune is our once-a-year sale, where you'll save 20 to 50% off our already low prices.
Of course, that doesn't include engagement rings.
Oh, yes, it does. We have hundreds to choose from.
But surely not high-end jewelry.
Tons of high-end jewelry.
You wouldn't dare include designer brands on that list.
Designer brands, on sale for a few more days.
This is madness.
It's your good fortune. Choose a fortune cookie, enjoy the discount.
You're ruining this for the rest of us.
Oh, cheer up, Sir Richard. Have a cookie.
We call them biscuits where I come from.
Restrictions apply. Visit the store or website for details. Good fortune sales ending soon at Tapper's Jewelry, Orchard Mall, West Bloomfield, Somerset Collection, and 12 Oaks Mall.
Welcome to Detroit, where summer weather can turn on a dime. Count on WWJ for AccuWeather updates every 10 minutes on the 8th. Detroit's news, weather, and traffic station. WWJ News Radio 950. Depend on us.
This is a special alert to all Americans who own a vehicle with less than 200,000 miles with an auto warranty about to expire or with no warranty coverage at all. Due to a decline in the economy, CarShield is announcing a low-cost, month-to-month vehicle protection plan that is now available to the public to save any driver out-of-pocket expenses on future auto repairs. Call now to find out how you can pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. Yes, you heard that correctly. Pay almost nothing for covered auto repairs. An open phone line has been established for all drivers to call for a free quick quote. Call 800-417-5101 now. Drivers who are covered will not have to pay for covered repairs again. This protection plan is at an all-time low. Additionally, drivers who activate this vehicle protection today will also receive free roadside assistance, free towing, and car rental options at no additional cost. Call us for your free quick quote today. 800-417-5101. That's 800-417-5101. What do you have to lose? Call 800-417-5101. Again, 800-417-5101. And podcasts. Radio.com is now Odyssey. Download the Odyssey app and listen to WWJ News Radio 950. World events are changing the price you pay for a tank of gas, even a loaf of bread. Get the latest on what this means to you. WWJ News Radio 950. Depend on us.
It is a tough drive due to all the road work going on. Also, a vehicle fire cleanup has closed the northbound US 23 exit ramp to Michigan Avenue. This is near Ann Arbor. We will check traffic and weather in 2.5 minutes. A Metro Detroit Congresswoman calling on the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services to assist Michigan with its monkeypox outbreak. Debbie Dingell, who represents the state's 12th district, led a letter with six of her Michigan colleagues to Secretary Xavier Becerra asking for more monkeypox vaccines and expanded diagnostic testing for the disease. Is a small cargo van about to go away?
Ford's Transit Connect, which was a North American Truck of the Year when it debuted, is reportedly about to be discontinued. Nissan, GM, Mercedes, and others have also retired their products. Ford isn't commenting, but Automotive News says the Transit Connect will end its run next year, a victim of poor sales.
WWJ Autobeat reporter Jeff Gilbert says at the same time, Ford is increasing the availability of its larger Transit van. Collective Popular Red Pine Cones in September and earn $100 by helping the Michigan Department of Natural Resources plant trees in state forests. Throughout September, you can pick up red pine cones and drop them off by appointment at several DNR locations in the Upper Peninsula. Foresters looking for freshness, proper storage, and most of all, the right species. Old cones or the wrong species of cone will not be accepted. Pedaling through the city to make for a safe and family-friendly environment, that is Detroit police officers on bike patrol.
It's Thursday. The bike-trained officers, along with neighborhood police officers, will be conducting enforcement efforts on quality-of-life issues. Chief James White says the bike patrols increase visibility for officers in a more personal way. This week, seeing 2 days of bike patrols on the city's east and west sides, tomorrow officers will be on the east side within the 7th Precinct. The roll call begins at 3:30 in the afternoon, with the bike patrol officers leaving for duty from 4 until 7. Jim Matthews, WWJ News Radio 950.
Oakland County Sheriff's investigators trying to piece together the details of a crash that has left a 53-year-old man in critical condition. The victim crashed into a pole at a car dealership at M15 and Dixie Highway with such force that his vehicle overturned and caught on fire. Fire crews rescued the Goodrich man, who was not wearing a seatbelt and was thrown into the back seat. Investigators say neither drugs or alcohol appear to be a factor in the crash. It is a celebration for a donor who has given blood for 40 years. The Upper Peninsula Regional Blood Center yesterday held a ceremony for Mark Johnson, who has donated over 55 gallons of blood since he first went to that center back in 1982. Johnson says giving blood is a way to give back and has become part of his routine. The center provides blood to 13 hospitals in the Upper Peninsula. WWJ News Time, 12:48. Traffic and weather together, and Trace McCaskill, a busy drive.
And we're watching a number of slow spots here, certainly, Brooke. This report sponsored by V's Barbershop. Checking the AAA jam cams, the crash is south on I-75. A 375 crashed there. Cars remain on the left shoulder. The delay is just minor. The vehicle fire cleanup continues here in that's the closure. Northbound US 23, the exit ramp to Michigan Avenue shut down there near Ann Arbor. Lower traffic for the work zone. This is the order of this Wednesday midday. A lot of road work in place, including some new work now. 75 north from Warren on to 8 Mile. A moving work crew on that right shoulder. They'll be there until at least 2:30. Delays ongoing for the work southbound I-75 from 14 Mile on to 696. A single lane closed with backups from Rochester Road. Westbound 696 near 275. The Flex Route construction has delays. In Monroe County, southbound US 23 at Ida West Road, a single lane closed until 3. Still about a 15-minute delay through this area. In the Fenton area, north and southbound US 23 at Thompson Road, a left lane closed. Traffic slower in both directions here. Again, the Tigers game getting underway at 1 p.m. has traffic en route to Comerica Park pretty busy right now. Seeing congestion along 75 North near M10 Grand River there. And a note, in downtown Detroit, Griswold between State Street and Grand River closed until further notice due to a sinkhole. So avoid that area. Whatever your delay, let's hear about that on the traffic tipster line, 248-423-6WWJ. I'll have your next look at traffic, 1258 for the Rapid Roofing Traffic Center.
Now the AccuWeather forecast from the Bill Bronford Weather Center.
Sun mixing with some clouds as we go through the rest of the day. It will be not too humid this afternoon, warming up to 86, and then mainly clear, mid-60s tonight. Tomorrow, it will start to get more humid with a chance of a shower thunderstorm later on, the high getting up to 85. Warm, still a bit sticky Friday, but it should be dry, partly sunny, low 80s, and then nice low 80s Saturday and mid-80s on Sunday with more humidity, but both days of the weekend look dry. I'm AccuWeather Meteorologist.